Hello everyone, my name is Sotisak Bunyang, nutritionist at COP Asia Pacific. The title of my video is Feed Quality Control. This video presents the concept and monitoring parameter of feed quality starting from ingredients to finished feed. In general, quality control focuses on three main components. The first component is ingredients. The second component is feed processing, where we input ingredients in this process. The final component is feed. Let's start with the first component, ingredients. Quality control includes physical characteristics, chemical composition, and biological contamination. Physical characteristics include texture, color, and odors. We can use our sensory organs to detect abnormal ingredients such as visual sense for abnormal colors and texture, smelling for abnormal odors such as rancidity in oils. Chemical composition, the routine analysis includes moistures, protein, lipid and fibers. Some parameters such as heavy metals can be periodically evaluated. This slide shows the example of chemical composition analysis in each ingredient. Different ingredients have different analysis programs. For example, corn should monitor moistures and protein, whereas rice bran should monitor moistures, protein, fat, fat, and fibers. Biological contamination includes pathogens, insects, and mycotoxins. Mycotoxins and pathogens can be monitored monthly, quarterly, or yearly, depending on risk. The second component is feed processing, starting from incoming raw materials until feed storage. Quality control during feed processing focuses on mixing, conditioning, pelleting, and storage. Let's start with the mixing process. In this process, feed uniformity or mixability must be focused. Percentage CV should be less than 10%. In the case of medicated feed, the prevention of carryover must be implemented. In the conditioning process, temperature, retention time, and addition of moisture should be monitored. These two parameters are involved in the reduction of pathogen risk and gelatinization enhancement. The next process is pelleting and crumbling. Pellet quality should be monitored during this process. Again, the prevention of carryover must be implemented in the case of medicated feed. The final components of quality control involve the feed itself, and it is quite similar to quality control for ingredients. We should monitor physical characteristics in every run to determine any abnormal feed textures, odor and color. Chemical composition should be evaluated in every run as well. Biological contamination can be analyzed periodically depending on the risk such as mycotoxins and pathogens. Thank you very much.